Special day in which we, in a more focused way than normal, celebrate the death and the resurrection of Jesus. And what better way to begin an Easter service in which we are looking at a real and hopefully a powerful way at the life and the death and the resurrection of Jesus than to begin this service with baptism, which is our way of identifying with the death and the resurrection of Jesus, symbolizing our uniting with Him in His death and His resurrection, and our death to an old life and resurrection to new life. So we hope this will be a worshipful time for all as we celebrate as a congregation and with this young man in his resurrection to new life in Christ. This is Erik Gaudette. Erik has invited Jesus into his heart, into his life, and it's his desire to follow the Lord Jesus in baptism. And in doing so, to begin in a public way, expressing that to you, his public profession to you, that he wants to identify with Jesus and obey him in this baptismal service. Erik, in obedience to the command of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ, and upon your public profession of faith in Him, I baptize you in the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Buried with Jesus in baptism, and raised to walk in new life with Him.
Let's all stand together and sing hymn number 159. Christ the Lord is risen fair. I stood in old Jerusalem beside the temple there. I heard the children singing, and ever as they sang, methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Methought the voice of angels from heaven in answer rang. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, lift up your gates and sing. Hosanna in the highest. Hosanna to your King. And then methought my dream was changed, the streets no longer rang. Hushed were the glad hosannas the little children sang. The sun grew dark with mystery, the morn was cold and chill, as the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. As the shadow of a cross arose upon a lonely hill. Jerusalem, Jerusalem, how the angels sing. And once again the scene was changed. New earth there seemed to be. I saw the holy city beside the tideless sea. The light of God was on its streets. The gates were open wide, and all who would might enter, and no one was denied. No need of moon or stars by night, or sun to shine by. That would not pass away.
All hail, King Jesus. All hail, Emmanuel. Will we ever understand a love so amazing that the King of Heaven, the Lord of Glory, would become a man clothed in human flesh and die in our place for our sins? When we consider so great a sacrifice, when we recognize His splendor and majesty, and when we experience His unending mercy and grace, we bow before Him and cry from the depths of our heart, all hail, King Jesus. Ministry had passed. The reputation of this teacher, healer, and miracle worker preceded him wherever he went. Approaching Jerusalem during his final days, Jesus was honored as king. Pressing around him, a large crowd called out, "Hosanna! Hosanna to the Son of David!" And as they chanted, the words of the psalmist were fulfilled before their eyes.
Lift up your heads, O you gates, that the King of Glory may come in. Who is this King of Glory? The Lord Almighty. He is the King of Glory.
Separated from his atoning work on the cross. Only a pure and sinless substitute would suffice. And so the King became a Lamb, the Holy Lamb of God.
In him we have redemption through his blood, the forgiveness of sins in accordance with the riches of God's grace. We who once were far away have been brought near through the blood of Christ. Worthy, worthy is the Lamb.
Worthy is the Lamb, worthy is the Lamb, and one.
and wealth and wisdom and strength and honor and glory and praise. You are worthy because you were slain, and with your blood you purchased men for God from every tribe and language and people and nation. Worthy is the Lamb.
Lamb. Centuries before, prophets had foreseen this event. One fateful night, as Jesus was praying in the garden, a large detachment of soldiers, together with a group of officials from the chief priests and Pharisees, approached him there. They sought out the one Judas called Master, and with no resistance, they seized him.
He was oppressed and afflicted. Yet he did not open his mouth. He was led like a lamb to the slaughter, and as a sheep before his shearers is dumb, so he did not open his mouth.
The armed guards hurried Jesus to the house of Caiaphas, the high priest, who, with the elders of the people, felt threatened by Jesus' claim to authority and by the throngs that followed him. There they ridiculed him, hurling insults and false accusations.
By oppression and judgment he was taken away, for he was cut off from the land of the living. For the transgressions of my people, he was stricken.
Led before Pilate, the Roman governor, the Savior of the world was subjected to brutal scourging as he endured the blasphemous abuse of cruel soldiers.
Yet it was the Lord's will to crush him and cause him to suffer.
Wanting nothing to do with this man, Pilate presented him to an angry mob who called out for his death. "Here is your king," he said, but the crowd shouted, "Take him away! Crucify him!" "Shall I crucify your king?" Pilate asked. But they screamed more insistently, "We have no king but Caesar! Crucify him! Crucify him!" Fearing what might result, if he took no action, Pilate shouted the proclamation, "Away with him! Let him be crucified!"
For he bore the sin of many and made intercession of the transgressors.
Thank you. All that I have, all that I am,
For God so loved the world that he gave his one and only Son, that whoever believes in him shall not perish, but have eternal life.
Eternal life, made possible only through the one who humbled himself and endured suffering, shame, and death on the cross. And when he had died, Scripture tells us that he was laid to rest, not in a grave befitting a mighty monarch, but in a borrowed tomb. But he arose. The empty tomb his followers discovered early that morning proclaimed to them, and still proclaims to us, that forevermore Jesus had conquered death and the grave. He had risen.
King of kings and Lord of lords.
The King is alive. But what does that mean to us today? Will we claim the victory, or do we live defeated lives? Perhaps the burdens of this very day have kept you from experiencing the joy he gave to give.
Thank you.
Jesus said, I am the resurrection and the life. He who believes in me will live, even though he dies. I am the first and the last. I am the living one. I was dead, and behold, I am alive forever and ever.
And one day, we who have been redeemed will join thousands upon thousands of angels and every creature in heaven and earth, worshiping him who sits on the throne. For the joy awaiting him, Jesus endured the cross, became a man obedient to death, and willingly gave his life for those he loved.
But we see Jesus now, crowned with glory and honor,
exalted to the highest place and given a name above every name,
that at the name of Jesus every knee should bow and every tongue confess that Jesus Christ is Lord. All hail King Jesus.